Hey there, it's me, just your average dude who loves weird science stuff. And boy, do I have a wild story for you today. Back in 2019, the Paris Zoo decided to show off this freaky thing they called a blob. Yeah, sounds like something out of a sci-fi movie, right? But this blob isn't some boring animal, plant, or even a fungus. It's like the oddball of nature, a yellow gooey slime that doesn't fit in any box. So why is it chilling in a zoo? Because this thing acts like it's got a mind of its own, more like a sneaky pet than a puddle of gunk. This blob doesn't just sit there looking gross. It moves. It crawls around like a slow motion ninja, not super fast, but fast enough to make you go, wait, what? It also eats stuff and gets bigger, sometimes growing as heavy as 20 kilograms. That's like lugging around a kid who's 5 or 6 years old. But here's the part that'll blow your socks off. This slime can remember things and even learn, like it's acing a brain teaser. I know, sounds nuts, right? Stick with me, I'll spill some crazy examples soon. So, what's this creepy slime monster? It's called a slime mold, and it's about as simple as a creature can get. These slime molds are like the ultimate minimalists. No brain, no heart, not even a bunch of cells working together. Get this, that whole 20 kilogram blob, it's just one cell, one. That's like if you were one giant cell with no nerves, yet somehow still smart. Scientists are losing their minds over this, studying it like it's the key to the universe. The more they poke at it, the weirder it gets. Let's dive into why this goo is such a big deal. First off, slime molds is a bit of a lame name for something so cool. People used to think they were fungi because they looked like sticky mold. Turns out they're protists, which is just a fancy way of saying weird living things. They love hanging out in warm, wet forests. Scientists argue about where to put them in the nature family tree, but one idea sticks them in a group called Amebozoa. The rockstar of the bunch is this yellow goo called Physarum polycephalum, the one everyone's obsessed with. So how does this slime survive without a brain or a to-do list? It starts life as tiny spores, like little eggs or seeds. These hatch into single-celled amoebas, which are super basic, with just one set of DNA, kinda like sperm or eggs. These baby amoebas scoot around eating bacteria, either wiggling through dirt or growing little tails to swim in water. When two amoebas that are like opposites attract, bump into each other, they smoosh together into one bigger amoeba, like a fertilized egg. This new guy keeps munching bacteria, growing until it's ready to level up. Here's where it gets wild. Instead of splitting into two cells like normal, slime molds just split their nuclei, the control centers, inside one big cell. The outer membrane stays the same, so it's still one cell, just with tons of nuclei. After a zillion splits, it becomes this massive cell with millions of nuclei and a giant blob of gooey stuff. That's the slime mold, you see, like a living pancake that can weigh as much as a big dog. As it grows, it's not picky about food. It'll gobble up bacteria, rotten plants, bits of organic junk, even fungi, turning it all into more slime. When food runs out or the weather gets weird, it's the time to make babies. The slime mold parks itself and sprouts these tiny mushroom-like things, skinny stalks with balls on top. These balls are packed with spores, ready to float away on the wind or hitch a ride with bugs. That's why people thought they were fungi for so long. They look like mini mushrooms. This closes the loop on their life cycle. Now, let's talk about why this slime acts like it's got a personality. No legs, no problem. It moves by pushing its gooey insides around, pulsing like it's got a heartbeat. Imagine squeezing toothpaste through a tube. That's how it crawls. These pulses come from proteins in its membrane that flex like tiny muscles, pumping the goo forward. It's slow, about a few millimeters an hour, but for something that's not an animal, that's like Usain Bolt speed. This pulsing doesn't just help it move. It's like a blood system spreading food around its body. Slime molds hunt like a living carpet, spreading out to find snacks, then piling on where the good stuff is, like kids swarming a pizza. Empty spots? They pull back, no energy wasted. It's like they're playing a strategy game and they're winning. They even act like they can smell. If there's yummy food nearby, they zoom toward it faster. If there's something gross, like salt, they steer clear. This sniffing makes them seem alive in a way that's almost creepy. But wait, it gets crazier. They're like mini computers. Japanese scientists did this awesome experiment where they put Physarum polycephalum in a maze with oatmeal as the prize. At first, the slime mold spread everywhere, checking every corner like a kid hunting for Easter eggs. Once it found the oatmeal, it pulled back, leaving just the shortest path to connect all the food. No detours, no nonsense. Another time, they set up oatmeal like a map of Japan's Kanto region, with Tokyo as the starting point. After 26 hours, the slime mold had linked all the cities in a pattern that looked scarily like Japan's train tracks. Engineers spent years designing that stuff, and this brainless goo nailed it. This trick has people geeking out. Designers in places like the US, UK, and Africa have used slime molds to plan roads and railways. Even space nerds are into it because the slime's networks look like the stringy bits of the universe tied to dark matter. They're thinking slime molds could help hunt for that mysterious stuff. Talk about a glow-up for a puddle of goo. But hold up, there's more. In 2008, some Japanese researchers found slime molds can keep time like a living clock. They blasted the slime with cold air every hour for 3 hours, and it slowed down each time to save energy. On the fourth hour, no cold air, but the slime still slowed down like it was expecting the chill. After a break, they hit it with cold again, and boom, it started timing the hours like it never forgot. A single cell with no brain, acting like it's got a calendar? That's bananas. Then, in 2016, French scientists showed slime molds can teach each other. Slime molds hate salt and usually avoid it, but you can train them to cross it for food. They set up 3 slime molds, 2 trained ones that didn't fear salt, and 1 scaredy cat in the middle. With a salt bridge between them and some food, the trained slimes merge with the nervous one. Guess what? The scared slime suddenly crossed the salt like it was no big deal, but only after mixing with its brave buddies. It's like they swapped notes and said, "Chill, salt's fine." This stuff makes you wonder what smart even means. We thought you needed a brain to learn or remember, but this goo says, "Hold my beer." It's got scientists scratching their heads, realizing we don't know half as much as we thought. Today, we've been vibing with Physarum polycephalum, the slime mold superstar. But there's another crew called cellular slime molds, like Dictyostelium, that live in gangs and act all social. They're so cool, they inspired a Japanese business legend, Kazuo Inamori, to come up with his amoeba management idea, where companies work like these teamwork-loving amoebas. That's a story for another day, but it's wild how a blob can spark big ideas. Slime molds are like nature's prank, showing us that even a single cell can be a genius. They're out here solving mazes, planning train routes, and keeping schedules, all while looking like spilled mustard. Next time you see some weird goo in the woods, it might just be smarter than you think.